This is the modified version of the previous program. I have changed the function sum. Remaining things are as it is. In this program, we'll study how to return an object from a function, from a memo function. The arguments of the function sum are objects of complex type, and the return value of this function is again a object of complex type. Let us observe the definition of the function, namely sum. So this is the return value of the function. This is the name of the class. Then resolution operator. Sum is a member function of this class. It has two arguments. Both are objects of complex type. Is it clear? Inside the function sum, we have declared another object, that is fourth object, namely t, which is of complex type. Then we have added real and imaginary data members of the object k1 and k2 and assigned them to the real and imaginary data members of the object t. After that, we have written the object t to the calling program. So this function will return an object t to the calling program. Is it clear to you? Understood this process? Let us see this step, which is the heart of the program. Press F4 key to execute up to this step. We are calling the function sum with arguments x and y. X and y are objects of type complex. Press F7 key. We are passing these objects x and y by passByValue method. So k1 is a copy of x and k2 is a copy of y. After that, we have created an object t which is of complex type. Let us see the diagram. You see, this is the class, namely complex, with two data members and three member functions. We have created three objects x, y and z inside the function main. After that, in the function sum, we have created an object t. And observe it. What we are doing? We have added the real data type of k1 and k2 and we have assigned it to the t.real. We have added k1.real, that is nothing but x.real, that is 1, and second one is k2.real, that is nothing but y.real, so 2. So 2 plus 1 is 3, and that we assign to the real data member of object t. Is it clear to you? See the second part. Now execute this one. What we have done? We have added imaginary data type of k1 and k2 object, and we have assigned it to the t.img. You see, k1.img means x.img. That is 3. k2.img is nothing but y.img, that is 5. So 5 plus 3 is equal to 8, and that value we assign to the img data type data member of object t. So t.img is nothing but 8. Is it clear to you? So after executing this statement, t.img is equal to 8. Now we are returning this object t to the calling function. So which object we are returning? This object. This object t we are returning using the function sum. And that is why we are return complex in the beginning of the function sum. It is a return value of the function sum. Is it clear to you? Well, so execute this last step, return the object t. And now see, this return object we have assigned to the object z. What we have done? Return value of this function sum we assign to the object z, and that is why this z is initialized by these values. Is it clear? Let us see. So after execution of this statement, after assigning the return value of sum to the z, we will get real is equal to 3 and img is equal to 8 in the object z. Is it clear to you? Now observe the last one, that is z dot display. So we are calling the function, member function display, using the object z, and it will display these two values at user screen. Is it clear? So press F8 key and see the result at dos prompt. 3 plus i8 is displayed. This 3 is the real data member and 8 is the imaginary data member of the object z. Is it clear to you?